Hi, you guys. This is Christina BX, and I'm coming in with another one. It's after Thanksgiving, so I want to say happy Thanksgiving. I hope everyone had a happy and healthy one. I hope you ate a lot. I know the last thing that you want to hear about is food, but I do want to come in with different products or different food samples that you can try in my November unboxing of Try the World. If you're interested in what I got, stay tuned. Okay, so this is what the box looks like when it comes in the mail. It comes in with a very significantly thick box, and it just says Try the World, and let's see what we got. So the first thing that comes out of your subscription box is your culture guide, and this month is from the country Spain. Woohoo! And I did open up the box previously, so I know what's in there. So this is why I'm even more excited for you guys to see what I got in my box, because this is amazing. But anyway, here we have our culture guide. So once you open up your culture guide, it gives you pictures and recipes. And it also gives you who prepared your box, as usual. And this is the man that created the box. His name is Jamie Bassanetti. I hope I didn't mess his name up. Here are pictures about Spain, recipes with the products that you have in your box, and just little tidbits and little things. And I do feel that you can learn a lot about a culture through their food. So if you follow the history of the food, it also goes along with the history of the country. So to really embellish on that, they actually send you information separately about Spain. And it gives you a guide of the kinds of foods they eat. On the back, it gives you a guide of the kind of produce, meat, and stuff that they primarily eat in Spain. And also gives you information about wine and olive oil. And pretty much you can just look through this and get another in-depth view of Spain. It also has a few websites on here, I think, that you can go into on the bottom. So that if you want to follow up on any more information about Spain, you can go to one of these websites and learn more about Spain. So then you get your card about your food. And I have quite a few products, so we're going to try to go through them really fast. Okay, so the first thing that I want to talk about that I got is olive oil. And what I like about the fact, this is the olive oil, it's from Allium Hispana. It's extra virgin olive oil, and y'all, this is good stuff. Y'all see how cloudy that is? That means that this is pure unrefined olive oil. That means that they didn't put anything in here. Here's the nutritional count, if you can see that. And if you look, what I like that's most when it says ingredients, right there, bam, just extra virgin olive oil. It doesn't say any other fillers, anything else. It's cloudy because that is what olive oil is supposed to be. It is actual olive oil, unrefined pressed. I can't wait to make a salad dressing or just eat this over something with some cheese and some olives. This is going to be great. The next thing that they sent me that blew me away, that's kind of out of the box, is this smoked paprika. Y'all, I live in the hood, you know. You go into the international aisle, you're pretty much targeted for whatever ethnicity is in your area in the international aisle. So smoked paprika, kind of not in our supermarket. Trust me and my mom have both gone in the supermarket and looked, and we find regular paprika, we find other things, but smoked paprika, we've been dying to get this, and I got this in my Try the World subscription. Can you imagine? And not a little sample, a tin that you would buy in the store. So this is quite a good amount. I want to try it and see exactly what the hype is about the spiced paprika. I'm definitely going to use this in a recipe. So what it says is, and I'm going to be very quick with this, it says paprika is a primary ingredient in many of Spain's best known dishes, including vegetable or seafood paella and patatas bravas. And they also have a recipe in the culture guide. Elvion, and Elvion is the brand of this. It's up here, Elvion. It's the makers of this. And it says, Elvion makes this one packaged in a collectible vintage tin with ripe peppers to maintain the spice's bright color and flavor. I can't wait to get in that. Y'all, it is hot in here. I'm also drinking my coffee, my spiked coffee. If you want to know, you see me sipping. This is a little bit of, it's a lot of coffee with a little bit of Bailey's. So, I'm enjoying my holidays. Hello. Anyway, so if you see me fanning, I'm just hot. So anyway, the next product I want to talk about that they sent, that I was very happy they sent this, and I'm glad. They sent some white tuna. And this is canned white tuna, a family company dedicated to the quality of their products, Espinola, which is the company that makes the tuna. It says, obtains Bonito del Norte, or white tuna, from tropical and subtropical waters around the world. Is delicious over crostini, tossed in salad, or mixed into warm rice dishes. So I'm going to enjoy this. The next thing that they sent me was a large jar of salsa tumacas con ajo. If I'm butchering this language, I apologize. Made with ripe tomatoes, olive oil, fresh garlic, and salt. This tomato sauce is delicious, spread over toast or served as a dip. And there's also a recipe in the cultural guide, and to show you how you can possibly use this. And this is not a small jar, y'all. This is a 8.1 ounce jar. So you get quite a lot of this stuff. The next thing that I'm gonna talk about that amazed me was I got another jar. But this jar is a floral jam. And if you can see it, it's jasmine petal jam. I have never. Have you ever? I've never. And inside the jam is a whole bunch, I hope you can pick that up, of jasmine petals. In this jam, I can't wait to eat this over toast. You know, over the holidays, you get up in the morning and you want something, you can just make some toast, make a bagel, make something, and spread this all over it. I'm going to try this. This is amazing. And the last two products, last but not least, are desserts. So they give you, you can have a salad with your tuna, make a salad dressing with your olive oil. You can use your paprika to season. You have your sauce that you can dip or spread over toast. And then they give you dessert. So I have two desserts. And one is the citrus crumble cake. I want to try this. I know this is good. Cortadillo is a traditional Spanish pastry flavored with cinnamon and lemon and filled with a cider cream. These crumble cakes continue to be made by hand according to a recipe that was developed over 100 years ago. So this is what the packaging looks like. You can see the little cake right there. This is who makes this. Inez Rosalie? The traditional way. The good way. So I'm going to enjoy this in a good way. And last but not least at all is El Almendro, and they make something called Tehran. And this is what it looks like. This is the packaging. And this is what the cookie looks like. It's yummy to me. And it says, since 1883, El Almendro has been producing Tehran, a popular holiday candy with raw ingredients and traditional craftsmanship. This one, made with crusted almonds, is crunchy and slightly sweet, a perfect pairing for coffee or tea. I shall bust this open right now because I got my coffee and I could eat this, but I'm not going to do that. I think they mean this for after dinner coffee. And I think that they do put together a good selection. So again, this is my November unboxing of Try the World. I recommend it. I think that you should try it at least once. There's no obligation. You start your subscription. You don't like the box you get, you cancel the subscription. It's not an obligation. I am not an affiliate. I have nothing to do with Try the World. I just ultimately love these products. I could not wait to do this filming, because as soon as I am done filming, I'm gonna start breaking these puppies open and eating them. I just didn't want to come on here and show you half-eaten containers and jars talking about this, you know, whatever. Anyway, this is Christina B. X. I am Products Junkie. This is my unboxing for November of Try the World, and the country is Spain, and Mr. Jamie Bisonette, whatever his name is, he did a bomb job with this box.